it up.
Super bright in here because of the snow. Welcome to February the 27th. It's about, it's 10:15. I woke up at 9, had a shower, washed my hair, still haven't dried it, so I'll do that next. Kettle is boiling for Lex. Coffee is on for me. Doggies have been outside playing in the snow. They find it very entertaining. Today is Tuesday. I had my two higher carb days on Saturday and Sunday. I went out for dinner with Lex on Saturday. I went out for brunch with my friends on Sunday. And my weight went up 1 pound, which is fine. That is not a big deal. 1 pound is not a big deal. I also have my period, which usually results in me going up about 2 pounds. And today I stepped on the scales and I was back down to 115, which is great. I'm back down to my pre-high carb day weight. I'm on my period and everything is good, apart from the snow, because I really want to get to the gym later. We did put salt on the driveway. That is our main problem, is that our driveway is quite long. There's a little bit of a slope and our cars do not like going up the drive when it's snowy. So Lex did put salt all over the driveway last night, but there was more snow than we expected. Boo! So I'm gonna go and have my carrot cake muffin, which I have every morning, a coffee. I'm gonna make like some tea, get some porridge on for him, and start the day. Just waiting for my phone to come back to life. I've just updated it. Hopefully it won't get slow. Sometimes with the updates, your phone goes slow. Then I'm gonna go and do some work. Also to do cardio. I have a call with my coach at about 1 p.m. because he's in the US, so we're doing early morning for him, afternoon for me. And then hopefully by the afternoon, I'll get Lex to clear the driveway so I can go to the gym and train glutes and hamstrings. I'm opting to do my steady state cardio at home with my two little coaches, simply because I want to get it done this morning and I can't get out the driveway right now. I don't want to risk it until Lex gets up. Once Lex gets up, I'll get him to do something with the driveway, make sure it's safe for me to drive on, and then I'll go to the gym and hopefully train there. If not, I may have to do some kind of at-home glute workout. I'd have to be inventive with that. Lex is out shoveling the driveway so that I can go to the gym. Roxy loves the snow. Look at her. Bailey's not that into the snow, are you, Bales? You don't like it. You want to stay inside with Mummy. So it is now 2:30 p.m. I did my cardio. I did a transformation picture for Instagram because I've been kind of keeping Instagram up to date as well. So I just wanted to show the difference in when I started to now. I officially started my prep 19 weeks ago. In the beginning, it wasn't too stringent. I had my honeymoon. I had Christmas where I didn't drop weight and even gained weight. So realistically, I started properly focusing in on my prep after Christmas. But it was 19 weeks ago when I started with my coach, and when I started tracking macros again properly, introducing cardio in. In those 19 weeks, I have lost 9 pounds. A lot of people are commenting or messaging me saying, how did you lose the weight so fast? Technically, I didn't lose it very fast. It's been 19 weeks and 9 pounds. I'm not ridiculously lean yet. I have a lot of fat still to lose. And I think it was quite realistic how I've lost the weight, and it hasn't been crazy fast at all. So don't think that what I'm doing is super fast or anything, because I do 2 check-ins with you a week. I feel like it is a very reasonable rate, a very normal rate for someone who's a natural bodybuilder, and I'm not using anything extra, like any drugs or anything like that, to help shift the weight. I'm doing this all through cardio and diet. So my weight loss is very realistic for anyone to follow. I had a call with my coach this morning as well, which was nice. I hadn't actually had a face-to-face call. It's been all over email. So it was nice to get that face-to-face contact and just sit and chat and talk about what we're gonna do over the next 5.5 weeks, what we're gonna do after that, peak week, all that kind of stuff. So it was very good to have that FaceTime with him. And it will get a bit harder over the next 5 weeks because he wants to bring me in as lean as possible. So we're going for major fat loss. I am going to drop a lot of fat over the next couple of weeks, and I'm going to follow it to the T because I am so OCD about hitting my targets and doing this prep. I want to do the best I can, not just for me, but for you guys, to show you what I can achieve and what a normal person, anyone can achieve just through diet and cardio. Nothing has changed with my training. My training split is right now a 4-day training split. I start off my week usually with biceps and triceps. Then the next day, which is today, is a glute and hamstring focused day. Then I will do a back and shoulder workout. And then on my last day, I'm back to legs and I do kind of quads, calves focused workout. And that is my split. I don't do any chest work because I feel like I incorporate chest into some of my tricep exercises, in some of my back exercises. And I don't like the idea of building up chest muscle. I incorporate abs maybe once or twice a week, depending on how I feel. Some weeks I don't do any abs because my abs just come out as I get lean and I drop body fat. But you know, if you've been following me for a while, that I have been training abs over the past year. For a while I was training them every day just to get them pumped and looking good. And I may start training them a bit more in the run up to the competition. People have been asking about what is carb cycling, how do you carb cycle? Now, carb cycling is where you drop your carb intake for a number of days to deplete your body, and then you reintroduce the carbs on higher carb days. Now, the way you cycle it, it can vary. Sometimes it's 3 low days followed by a high day, 4 or 5 low days followed by 1 or 2 high days. So it does vary how you carb cycle, and you will find that different carb cycles work better for different people, and even for yourself, depending on where you're at in your prep and your fat loss. Carb cycles can be a great way to kick start plateaued fat loss. At the moment, I'm doing 5 low carb days followed by 2 high carb days. Now, the only thing that changes in my macro intake is the carbs. My calories will obviously go up with the increase in carbs, but my fats and protein remain the same on the high and the low carb days. See, I made it to the gym. I did a really good hamstring glute focused workout. It was just 4 exercises, but I felt they were really effective, and a lot of them were quite compound exercises, so they were using a lot of muscles. I'm just in now. I went to Lidl, stocked up on loads of flowers, got some lovely roses here, and I've got some lilies in the other room and some daffodils, and I just filled the house with flowers because it's so cold and wintry out. I wanted to bring a bit of summer and sunshine inside. I'm gonna have a coffee now. I just had one of those little chicken breasts that I get from Muscle Food, and that'll keep me going until dinner. I've made Lex soup and a sandwich. Coffee time for me, and then dinner. Dinner is a collection of pre-prepared veggies, fish, quinoa, and I can't wait. I love dinner time. Breakfast used to be my favorite meal until I started this prep. Now I'm all about dinner. I do love breakfast too, but it's dinner time and I'm having some smoked cod mixed with the collie rice and quinoa and lentil bags that I get from Asda. And then I've got some pre-prepared Brussels sprouts, butternut squash, and what else do I have in there? That's it for now. And I've got some pak choy in the oven. I like to oven bake it with some balsamic vinegar and some seasoning. And then I've also made kind of like my own healthy tartar fish sauce. So what I did was I got quark, which is really high in protein. So per 100, it's 11.5 grams of protein. And I've mixed in some capers, some salt and pepper, and some garlic. Now it is very garlicky, so I stink after it, but it adds just a really nice flavor to the fish and keeps it interesting. So I demolished my dinner and now I am on to what I consider dessert. Sad times. But it is one of those Activia, Danone Activia yogurts, but it's like a muesli flavored one, and it really does taste like there's muesli in it, and I love me some muesli, but you cannot fit muesli into your macros. Not the best of times, to be honest. So I'm gonna have one of these, and they're less than 10 grams of carbs, no fat, and I'm gonna add in some chopped mixed nuts because I need to add in some fats for the day. So this is my way of getting in some healthy fats. Final meal of the day, or snack of the day, before I hit the bed and get some sleep. I'm having hot chocolate. It's a great way to fulfill any of the sweet cravings you're having while you're dieting, and the options ones are only like 5 grams of carbs, and I added in some coconut almond milk, and I'm going to enjoy it with one of these bad boys. These are my protein chocolate truffles. I make them. You know what, I'm not gonna give you the recipe because you have to go to my cooking channel. These are super easy to make. You can make them like in a half hour. That includes like putting them in the fridge and stuff like that. And they're so tasty, so chocolatey, and have really good macros as always. So go check that out. It's on my cooking channel, my truffle recipe. I'm gonna leave it here for today, guys. Gonna get some sleep. I'll check in with you at the weekend, because this weekend I have Margarita coming with number one, my bikini, and number two, to teach me how to pose, because I cannot for the life of me remember how to do proper bikini posing. So I've got Margarita coming to give a helping hand. See you at the weekend. Cause if I only had 100 fans, I'd take them all to dinner, talk about the people that we used to be. If I had 100 fans,